preach the gospel of Jesus, and we're on our way to London, and we're heading back. Pray for us. Heading back
hallelujah,
to London.
Hallelujah.
Name, hallelujah.
Scotland, we come to you to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ. We're going to call you out from your sins, Scotland, for you to repent, Scotland, for you to get right with God. Now is your time to get right with God. Don't wait till tomorrow, because you may not get tomorrow. Don't wait next week, because you may not get next week. Don't wait next month, because you may not get next month. Why is it throughout the whole world that people are living confident in their flesh today? Why is it throughout the world that people are walking around, driving around, not thinking about their soul today? Why is it that people laugh at the preaching of God's word when they know that they're going to face God on judgment day? Why is it that people want to wait till they die in order to actually turn to God and then realize it's too late?
Come on. Come on.
I'm going to tell you today, God is real, my friends.
Yes!
I'm going to tell you today that you and your sins separate you from God. But I have good news for you, that despite your sins separating you from God, God sent his son Jesus Christ 2,000 years ago to lay down his life as a willing vessel to bring you near to God.
Yes.
So you won't get close to God through your Pope.
Come on.
You won't get close to God through Muhammad.
Yes.
You won't get close to God because you're a good person. I have bad news for you, my friends, that if you're outside of Jesus Christ, you're bad. You're a sinner. You're in need of Jesus Christ. It's not safe for you to die in your sins. Are you confident that you will be in heaven? Are you confident that you have truly been made right with God? Are you confident?
Allah cannot save you, bro. Can't save you. He didn't die for you.
Are you confident today that God has truly pardoned your sins?
He did.
Are you not concerned about the afterlife, Scotland?
Wanna have a conversation?
Many were concerned.
Wanna have a conversation?
COVID. Many people were concerned about the pandemic. But what about your soul, Scotland? What about what Jesus Christ did on the cross for you? I'm telling you today that God is merciful. I'm telling you today that there's still grace available for you today.
Come on. The guys in blue, they're here.
You can't take your money with you.
Hold the phone.
You can't take your cars with you.
Hold the phone.
We came into this world with nothing, and we're going to leave this world with nothing, ladies and gentlemen. It's time to get serious about God. It's time to get right with God, Scotland. Don't you see the writing on the wall? Don't you see that we're living in the last days? Don't you see that in the Bible it says that people will call good evil and evil good? Don't you see in the society we live in today that people say that they were born as a girl, but they call themselves a man? Don't you see what's in our society today? Oh, the judgment of God towards those that have not yet repented. My friends, if hell was not real, I would not leave Chicago, Illinois, of the United States of America to hop in a plane to come 8 hours to tell you about a fairy tale.
Where's your
plane to repent?
That's why it's still being preached.
It's time to get right with God. And many people are talking about, you need to shut up, preacher.
Come on.
You're coming up with
preachers,
preacher.
Come on.
No one wants to hear that. But yes. I'm going to tell you today, there's people in hell wishing they could hear this message.
Come on. Preach.
You don't have to spend eternity in hell. But you know what blows my mind when I go out throughout the world and preach the gospel is people walk around and they're confident like they're not going to die one day and face God. You know you can't take your car with you.
Come on.
You know you can't take your bank account with you. You know you can't take your children with you. When you stand before God, it will be you by yourself.
Yes.
I don't come to condemn you.
I don't come to send you to hell because I don't have the power to do that, but I do want to warn you. Scotland, use your logic.
Hey!
Scotland, use your mind.
Come on!
Is it truly loving? Is it truly logical to warn people about the coming judgment? Is it truly loving to tell people about the wrath of God today? Is it truly loving to tell your son or daughter, don't put your hand on the stone because you might burn it? That's love, my friends.
Come on!
Oh, what a great love it is.
Yes!
Jesus would lay down his life for the ungodly. Jesus laid down his life for people out here today throughout Scotland that may not repent. That's a true love. Will you lay down your life for somebody that won't represent you well after you lay down your life for them?
Come on!
Jesus, Jesus is the author of love.
Come on, preach!
Jesus is love. He is the embodiment of love.
Come on!
He loved everyone. And love is not compromise.
Come on!
Love does not excuse you of your sin. Love calls you out of your sin.
Come on!
Come out from your darkness.
Come on, come on.
Come out from your sin.
Come on.
Your secret sin, God has seen. Your sin that other people have seen, God has seen. Nothing is hidden under the eyes of God. What about America? I'm from America. And Great Britain is very similar to America. There's many people that are implied today. I'm not talking about LGBTQ.
Hey!
People that are outside of Jesus Christ walking around knowing that they're going to die one day and walk in pride.
Come on!
They're not concerned about where their soul is going to go.
Come on! Come on!
Now is your time. Now is your time, Scotland, to call in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes!
Now is your time to bow down to Jesus.
Come on!
Don't bow down to the Queen, bow down to Jesus. The King is coming.
Yes!
The King is coming.
Yes!
He's like the statue, I don't even know who this is, but Jesus is going to come on a white horse.
Come on!
The second coming of Christ. He came in the flesh, and he spoke among the people. He was a 12-year-old boy that would walk into the synagogue and talk about the Torah. But I want to tell you today that the second coming of Christ is not going to be what it first was. He's not going to come back asking questions. He's not going to come back doing healings and miracles.
Come on!
He's not going to come back and preach the gospel.
Come on!
He is the gospel.
Yes!
He's going to come against those that have been disobedient to him.
Come on!
Wake up, Scotland! Hell is forever! Are you serious about your soul? And why wouldn't I yell if this was not important? You think the news will tell you this? No! They want to feed you propaganda! They want to feed you propaganda!
Come on, preach!
Today, they watch all of the news without the news actually telling you what's really happening, what's really going on versus Ukraine and Russia, what's really going on in Iraq, what's really going on in America, what's really going on behind closed doors. I have news for you. It's called fake news, and many people bought the fake news. Leave the false prophets. Leave the fake pastors. Not saying that all pastors are frauds, but there are some frauds out here today in the world. They don't care for your soul. I'm calling out to you, Scotland, to get right with God. I'm calling out to you to get right with God, to repent and believe in the gospel of Jesus Christ. Where will it be? Will this be your day? Will this be your time? Isn't it crazy that people will put faith in a mask, but won't put their faith in God? The mask may protect you, but your body will drop sooner or later. You're an eternal being. God made us to live forever. He put eternity in all of our hearts. Where are you going to go, my friends?
Come on!
It's time to get right with God. It's time to confess your sins. All the guilt and shame that you carry, you can experience the forgiveness of sins. It's time to repent. It's time to come clean before God. While God is merciful, while God is gracious, while God is kind, while God is patient. Time to cry out to God, Scotland. There is no such thing as good people. And I'll leave you with this. If you're a good person, won't you put all your thoughts that you think every single day on a projector screen for everybody to see the thoughts that you think? Would you be good then? Would you lose your spouse? Would you lose your family members? Would you lose your cousins because of the thoughts you think? You will be held accountable not by your thoughts, not just your thoughts and your words, but also your deeds. It's not safe for you to die in your sin, Scotland. It's not safe for you to die in your sins, but it is safe for you to repent and run to the arms of God, the only one that can forgive you of your sins, the only one that can make you right before Him. Christ didn't come to make you good. Christ didn't come to make my brothers good. He came to make us look like Him. So many people say that they're Christians today. Just because I sit in the garage, does that make me a car? You gotta repent. You tell me to shut up, but there's many people in hell that wish they could hear this preaching. You know you're about to give up the ghost. And what's crazy is many people throughout the world, they walk around with confidence, and they don't even know that they're going to die. You have on your phone, on your calendar, on the day that you're going to die?
Come on!
Isn't that serious for you? That when you die, you're going to face God in judgment?
Hey! Preach!
You will attack you, you will social media, you will propaganda, you will things that the devil can do. It's time to repent.
Come on!
Get right with God, Scotland. This is your sign. You may not like the sign, but this is your sign. Because God loves you to warn you about the coming end of the world. God bless you, Scotland. And repent and believe in the gospel of Jesus Christ, the death and burial and resurrection.